Domine. Are you nervous? Understandable. Every warrior is nervous on the day of the battle. It is perfectly fine, as long as you can still be in control when you draw your blade. He's a speculator. It would be foolish to trust a soldier whose primary weapon is deception. It can be a challenge if you find it difficult to trust him, but every challenge is an opportunity. Know that he's deceptive by nature and try to learn from him. How do you feel about it? You will always have to do things you're not particularly fond of in order to win in the end. But if you're not willing to pay the price, you can simply stop playing. That's what I would have done. What I have done.
I am here. I am not. I have seen these bandits. They are worthless as opponents. It will not be a boring day, for we will be fighting, but exciting. I doubt that. Flames lit the skies in a glorious display of celebration and sent fear to the hearts of our enemies. They must be trembling now. Then those who have seen it will tell the tale. And in dreams, everything is larger. He has skill. You can tell by the way he handles the bow and the blade. Some are just born to fight. He's one of those for sure. He will fight until he dies. God save it will be sooner or later.
Something on your mind, kid? No doubt. A battle is first won in your mind, kid. If you think you're going to lose, then you certainly will. I was surprised, too. I was told Greek oak is both fire and waterproof, but they burnt easily enough. I wonder what they're thinking, now their fleet is gone. Every problem has a solution. That's what Warcraft is all about. In my experience, it's not age that determines the proficiency of a warrior. Not necessarily. Stubbornness and arrogance can also come with age. Look, I have met warriors like, him. Things may not always be what they seem. Wait until you pass judgment.
That's close enough. What do you want? Why? It really isn't. No offense, but information is the most dangerous thing in my line of work. The less you know about me, the better it is for both of us. A few seasons. Lucullus has a knack for recognizing talent. He immediately saw me for what I was. A killer. I am not. Rome is a place of stasis and passivity. Here, I feel alive. Sure, as long as I'm not in Rome. Imagine a door that is locked. And imagine you need to open that locked door, preferably discreetly. But someone else has the key. Now, you can always smash the door into pieces with a great hammer. Indeed. And then we take the key. Usually off his dead body. Why? Are you going to remember my birthday? Some people just don't like to talk about themselves.
You seen Aegler again tonight?
I've seen her for the last time.
What happened?
She gave me some kind of disease. I'm not the first one either, apparently.
Ouch. I'll stay clear as well then.
Please excuse me.
Solway. Interesting. I shall accept this as a compliment. But prepare to be disappointed. to the extent of my knowledge and ability, I shall try to be as helpful as I can. Indeed. Staying in Rome became, shall we say, politically disadvantageous to me. That's why I left it. Like you, I've never been to Lesbos before. I did my homework, though, in case you have any questions. Location, I would guess. The island has countless coves and natural harbors for pirate ships to hide in. Not to mention the massive fortress in Mutilene. Lesbos is one of the most important islands on this sea. Some cartographers call it the Horse Island, on account of its shape. Of course. Fascinating, isn't it? The Legion can build a fortified camp like this almost overnight. In my opinion, that is the foundation of Rome's military might. Does it matter? For the sake of this discussion, let us say he was a traitor. In the end, we are triumphant and the pirates are dead. The Triarchus, if indeed he worked with them, now knows he picked the wrong side. In a war like this, allegiances are rarely about ideology. The common person wants nothing more than to be on the winning side, and we have shown Geminus that the winning side is ours. Wait. Listen. You seem trustworthy. I may have need for your help on a rather sensitive matter. Your caution is well placed, but the sensitivity of the matter is rather personal in nature. I have tried pursuing a solution myself, but to no avail. I've been keeping a detailed account of our journey ever since we left port. Shortly after our arrival, however, the journal went missing. I believe it to be stolen by one of the Centuriones. I have seen a particular man walking out of my tent. As a matter of fact, I have already confronted him and he pretty much admitted his guilt. Pain comes in many forms, physical, emotional, and let us say that some men just enjoy inflicting pain in all forms. That, I have already tried. He threatened me in a way. He said if I continue bothering him, he would read the contents of my journal publicly. I can stand by my decisions, and I'm proud of my actions. It's just that I don't want some donkey-headed brute reciting them in public. Roman law is valid in Rome, and our perpetrator knows this. This is a personal matter, and therefore it should be solved personally. The Centurio is called Agrippa, I think. He hangs out with his friends near the tent over there. I thought perhaps you could convince him to hand over my journal. Needless to say, I would like to keep the contents of the journal private. I would appreciate if you'd refrain from reading it.
Salve, Domine.
Ah, I would march into battle naked if it meant they could afford to feed us better.
Good night.
Solway.
Salve, Trapune.
We're in the middle of something, Tribune. What do you want? This? Ah, well, this is priceless. A journal written by Cotter's stupid nephew, who thinks of himself as the greatest commander history has ever seen. Why don't you send him back here to beg for it again? For this worthless drivel? Now that's a bargain. Take it.
The pirates are getting bolder. They attacked another one of our galleys. This morning.
Geminis tell you too?
That's right.
This is the second time his galley's been attacked, and yet he still lives.
Solway, I see you have successfully retrieved my journal. May I ask how you managed it? You paid out of your own pocket. I don't know what to say. Thank you. I'm literally in your debt. Let no one ever say Gaius Iulius Caesar owes money. Here, take it. One last question before we're done. Did you read my journal? That is the most virtuous thing to do, and I expected nothing less of you. Thank you, my friend.
The smoke of the fires still hang as a thick carpet above Mytilene. I am impressed with your ability to cause mayhem. Humility is a quality a capable man should always possess, providing it is backed by skill. Very well. Lucullus has told me much about your upbringing and your training, but war is much different than personal combat. Before we leave, go to the practice area and seek out Garvius, who trains the Speculatores. He will teach you a few last important things.
Need something?
At your service.
Salway, did Thermos send you my way? You have the bearing of a man who knows how to handle himself. I used to be. Now I train the Speculatores. It's how I came by my cognomen. You know how to fight, but you've never been to war, have you? Well, the Legion is marching out soon, so we don't have time for the full regiment anyway. Let me show you how to use a pilum, and maybe how to bandage a wound, if it comes to that. Call over your friends, and we'll get started. Alright, let me see how good your throwing arm is. Aim that pilum for my shield. A tip is designed to break off and stick in the shield, making it difficult to use.
Covering this area.
Thank you.
can keep that equipment. Hope it serves you well at Mytilene.